Good evening and welcome to another virtual Sunset Salsa event. This is part of Hudson River Park's 2020 Summer of Fun season, which is of course coming to you live from tonight, Hudson River Park's Pier 40, where our offices are. We are joined by some fantastic special guests this evening. For more information on all of Hudson River Park's free virtual programs this year, please visit hudsonriverpark.org. We have a full calendar of events, including music, children's programming, STEM learning. We have virtual summer camps and lesson plans for you and your families to do at home, as well as weekly salsa lessons with our fantastic partner who has been bringing salsa to the park for more than 5 years. We couldn't do this event without her. We are so happy to have her join. For again, more information on Hudson River Park's virtual events, please visit hudsonriverpark.org. And we are just waiting for Talia to join us, and then we will be able to continue our wonderful program for you tonight. So if you would like to dance along with us, we have a Spotify playlist on our Spotify channel. You can find us at Hudson River Park on Spotify. And we hope that you will dance along. We will just put the Spotify playlist in our comment section here for you. And we're just waiting for Talia. Hello, Talia. You're just connecting to audio, so we'll. It's great to have you, Talia. How are you? And would you please introduce all of our. You're back. We can see you. Perfect.
This is good. Okay, let me.
Yeah, that's great.
You guys can see me well, and good to be back. Let me make sure I can see everyone. Yeah, you can hear me.
We can hear you, absolutely.
I cannot see Adriano and Samantha yet.
Okay, well, I would say if you can, just hit gallery view on Zoom and then we will be able to see.
On my phone, so let me check quickly.
You might have to just swipe over to the side and then it shows all of the boxes together.
There we go.
Perfect.
All right. Oh, hello, I should be saying, let me practice my French. Let me practice my French. I feel like I'm so rusty, but I am so excited, Kira. Thank you so much for the introduction and the opportunity to be able to continue our virtual Sunset Salsa, which is one of New York's most exciting adventures that we have in New York and that we all miss so much. And happy to be here with Adriano and Samantha from Montreal. They are three times world salsa champions, and I have to admit that I didn't know about you guys, and so happy Anya Katzefman, another amazing world champion judge, choreographer, friend of yours, told me about you guys. So I YouTube you, of course, and found out all these amazing videos, and I was pretty amazed at your choreography, your authenticity, because one of the things that often you don't see when you watch performers outside of New York, it's like, how great are they? You know, New York salseros are very famous and very well known, but you guys, I mean, are you Cuban? I mean, you look so Cuban, and I love that you have a lot of Afro-Cuban in your choreography. And that's always, you know, when it comes to salsa, we always look for authenticity, and you have a lot of that in your choreography. Is that something that you do in purpose? Cuban, a lot of that Afro-Cuban, because I know you are dancing New York style on two, but you are adding a lot of these, you know, elements that are, you know, back from where Cuba comes from, where salsa comes from, Cuba. So is that something that you do on purpose?
I wouldn't say on purpose. I think it's just when we do choreography, we try to mix up all of our repertoire, and depending on what the music calls for more so than anything else, or what we feel in that moment is usually what we try to produce while we're choreographing. And then on stage, we present it, right? So I think it's part of our process. We always try to make things work. If it's a shine section, that I want to execute that's more mambo or something that I hear that is a little bit more Afro-Cuban, then we'll put in the essence of that moment depending on what the singer is singing or the music is playing, the rhythmical pattern. So depending on that is usually how we try to choreograph our pieces and our own inspiration.
Yeah, I think it always comes down to the music, right? We try to be as authentic to that music as possible.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely.
And how long have you both been dancing to, you know, separately and then together? What is that like when you're finding a dance partner and getting to know someone both as a partner, having danced with other people and, you know, maybe dance solo dance? What is that like for you?
Well, for Samantha and myself, we've been dancing together since we were little kids. So I wouldn't be able to say I've had that many dance partners. Because we really stuck to each other for a really long time now. We started, we were about 10 years old, and we continued. Now we're 25, so it's been 15 years. And yeah, we just started together and we kept going, and our goals were always kind of on the same page most of the time. So we continued and eventually opened our studio and went on to win world championships as well. And yeah, we've just been always working together. So we were very committed at a young age, and we knew what we wanted for dance, and we really wanted to share it with the rest of the world, like we're doing right now. So this is such a beautiful opportunity for us to be able to get to see some New York salseros, and you know, coming from Montreal and being in the Mecca city of it, right? So for us, it's a pleasure to be here and a pleasure to be doing what we love to do.
We're so happy to have you. Thank you again. And what are maybe some tips that you would give for beginners as they're starting? You know, maybe now, like me, they're not as familiar, but now that we're at home, we can kind of dance without the, you know, everyone watching. How do we get comfortable as beginners? What are things that we should keep in mind? I've heard, listen to the music and don't think about, you know, just move more. Is there anything else that you think would be helpful?
Well, obviously taking classes is important. It's important to go get the right knowledge and the right information, right? So that you develop the technique and that eventually you're able to just put that music on and freestyle and improvise and put together all of that material that you're learning, right? So I think it's definitely important to have a weekly class or a bi-weekly class or whatever it is that fits into your schedule or your budget, but just to keep an open mind to that knowledge and keep training that, and then of course putting into practice, right? So obviously we have less socials nowadays and we hope that they come back soon.
Yeah.
But we can all, you know, practice from home, put on our music and just dance, right? And make sure that we keep our bodies in tune to that. I think it's super important.
That's great. Well, if you are ready, we would love to start tonight's lesson.
Yeah, I have a question. I have a final question. So do you guys been dancing since you're 10 years old? Did you always salsa dance, or you started with ballet and jazz and other styles? I'm very curious.
Oh, no, we started in salsa, straight up.
Always salsa.
Yeah. Wow, you dove right in, huh?
Yes. Yeah, we fell in love with the music, though, more so than anything else.
Wow.
We fell in love with it, and then we started taking classes and just kept going and never really stopped.
We were exposed to the world of showcasing and competition from a young age, so it was always part of our vision and part of our goals to pursue that. So yeah, we fell in love with it young and stuck by it, and here we are today.
That's amazing.
That's fantastic.
That's really cool. I am going to join with my other computer. I don't know why it crashed, Kira, but if that's okay, it will be a lot easier, so I don't have to hold this little phone. And I think we're ready to start dancing with you guys. So this is great. So Kira, if you can help me, I'm going to try to connect. I think it's connecting right now.
Yep, you just want to turn on the video on your computer and then you should be ready to go.
Okay, I'm going to turn off the phone then, and we're going to start with Adriano and Samantha.
All right, you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
This is a warm up. All right, so just some basic steps. We're doing this class on two, of course. So I don't assume that that's a problem for you guys in New York. So just follow along. We're going to focus on a bit of body movement, just try and copy what you see, and we'll explain some of that a little bit later. All right?
Great, great. So we'll start dancing, which is what we really want to move. So I am ready to move.
A little warm up.
Excellent. Sounds great. Exciting. Show-offs, you guys are show-offs. I love it, I love it. You know you're training with salsa world champions when you are trying to breathe through the salsa because you guys are going right for it. I love it. That's good. I want Samantha at least to break down the heel step because I'm also wearing my 5-4-inch heels. Mm-hmm. So I always wonder how you can do those so fast. And that, you know what I mean? It's like, how do you do the heel thing when you're on high heels? So for all my ladies, let's see, we have a lot of people connected. So for all the ladies that are watching this and want to know how to do these funky moves on heels, let's hear from Samantha. Samantha, you want to break that one down for us?
Absolutely. Yeah? That's a really good question. I get this question often. Of course, when we're wearing the high heels, it's very hard to put the weight on our heel and actually properly produce a weight transfer, right? So when I'm in high, if I'm in a shorter heel or if I'm in flats, I'll go right ahead and do the step exactly the way Adriano does it, or his men do it with the weight transfer off of the heel. So anything that is a kind of twist or a tap with the heel, I can do, right? But this particular step that we did, I'm actually going to mark it off of the ball of my foot so that I don't lose tempo, right? I don't lose time off of the heel. So I'll break that down. If we come from the basic, 4, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. What we did here was cross on one, and then we start going forward, forward, back, back. So forward, forward, back, back. We're going to rotate. Forward, forward, back, back. Right? So then what I'm trying to do is mark my step off of the inside edge of the ball of my foot so that when I transfer my weight, I'm also going to get a bit more hip movement. Right? So that I use the weight transfer to roll the hip always backwards, out and back, out and back. And I'm going to do this over every step. Right? So let's try that again. Basic. 1, 2, 3, 5. Here we go. 1, 4, 2, 3, back, 4, 5. Other side. 6, 7, 8, and 1. Back to base. Yes, let's try one more time.
Yes. And just for the men, what I'm doing is I'm going off of the heel for this step. So if you wanted to mark it on your toes, that works as well. Just depends the intention that you want to give. But for myself, I like to go off of the heel. And I also do a slight rotation once my weight is on it. So when I'm stepping on it, I twist the heel slightly. Well, the toes, I mean, open slightly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and back to basic. 2, 3, 5. Okay? We'll try it together again. One,
yes.
5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3. Here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay? So the step is slightly faster just because we're on the whole count, right? So we're marking every step, count in the music, right? So it is a slightly accelerated comparing to a basic step, but we just keep it consistent up until we come back to 1, 2, 3, back to basic time. Okay?
Beautiful. Makes sense.
How do you feel with that?
Yes, that makes a lot of sense. That makes it now doable. Yes, yes.
Okay.
I love it. Yes.
Okay, so we're going to get into a little section together so that you guys can all follow along with us. And we'll be able to coordinate it, doing it all together at the same time.
Yeah, we're going to take it slow, going about 2 weeks at a time. We'll practice with music. We'll come back to explanations. So if you guys have any questions, feel free. And Talia as well. Yes?
Right.
Here we go. So we're going to start with, of course, one basic. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Okay, for ladies, of course, whether you're wearing heels, you can follow me. If you're in flats, you can actually try all the heel steps like Adriano is doing. So let's go one more time. From the top, basic. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. We're going to cross over and go into a Suzy Q. 1, 2, 3. And we're going to cross over on 4, transferring our weight onto the left leg. Okay, so one more time. Basic, Suzy Q, cross on 4. Here we go. 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 5. Here we go. Suzy, 1, 2, 3, cross 4. Yes, from here, we're going to step out on 5. We're going to tap 6, 7, tap 8, and back to basic, 2, 3, 5, 4 now. All right, so one more time slowly. From the Suzy Q, we cross over, starting with the right leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, step out 5. Come in 6, 7, 8, and 1. 2, 3, 5. One more time, a little bit faster. 5, 6, 7, go. 1, 2, 3, 5. Suzy Q. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
So we're gonna add the arms with that section. So what we're gonna do here is our basic 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. We start our Suzy. 1, 2, 3, cross 4. Once I open on 5, I'm going to extend the left arm out and bring it back in and extend the other way and bring it back out. I know with a hit. So boom, bah, two, three. Yeah? One more time. So we'll try slowly from the top. One basic, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3. Here we go. 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3, cross, 4, open, 5, 6, 7, 8, and basic, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. One more time. A little bit faster. 5, 6, 7, and a basic, 2, 3. Here we go. 6, 7, a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 5, 6. Yes?
Yes.
Perfect. And we'll keep going. And then we'll try with music. Okay? We'll do one little part more. Okay? 5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, 3. 5. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Cross 4. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. Okay? Once we finish. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we'll do that one more time. So we finish.
So we're here, let's move from the last part. 5, 6, 7, 8. So at this point, my weight should still be on the left leg. I'm going to cross over and weight transfer onto the right, which is now going to become my supporting leg. So I transfer on 1, and I'm going to tap 2, and tap 3, and only transfer again on 4. Yes, so again, I'm on my 8, left leg, I cross over, 1, left leg. From here, we're going to go tap, tap. So both taps are happening with my left foot. My 2, I'm going to slightly rotate the knee inwards towards my center. Yes? So that's my 2, 2, and then I'm going to completely open and try and tap behind my standing leg. Right? So we really see that clear shape where we're crossing the foot on 3. And then I'm going to finally transfer onto my left leg on the 4, releasing the right.
And for the men, this part, I lift the heel as well. So once we do 1, 2, 3, 4, I push off of my heel to step onto my left and weight transfer on my left, and I go up with the right foot. Okay?
And for the ladies, 2, 3, I push off of the ball of the foot, my right foot. And on the 4, I'm going to lift my heel, so I really just have my leg extended in a full turn up on 4.
Okay, try that one more time. 5. We'll take it from 5, 6. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I messed up. I'm gonna do that again. 6, 7, and 5, 6. 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, one more time. 5, 6, 7, here we go. And 1, 5, 6, 7, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes?
So, wait, I lost you there for a minute. Can you explain the transition? Because we're going right into it, right?
Yes.
We're gonna try and take it from the top slowly and put it all together.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. 5, 6, 7, and basic, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah?
Let's break it down one more time. 8 and basic, 2, 3, 5. Susie Q. 1, 2, 3, 4. Open 6, 7, 8. Cross 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so what happens, what's quick right now is that we're starting off with a whole count right away, right? Which means that we're not using our musical pauses for an 8 that we usually have in our basic, right? Which would be basic timing. So we're starting it a little quick. 1, 2, 3, you want to transfer right away on the 4, where normally we'd hold, right? So this is what's going to allow me to hook into the next step and transition by 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? Again, and then from here, as we said before, the weight should stay on the left leg so that right away I tap, cross over one more time, release the weight so I can tap, tap, and transfer one more time, okay? Again, from the top of the count. 1 basic, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, here we go. 1, 2, 3, step 4, 5, 6,
it again.
Music?
Sure, let's try it. Let's try it with the music. How's everyone doing? Let me check.
El paso, mucha salsa rápida, it's fast. So if we haven't been dancing, everyone, now you know that you gotta keep in shape so you can stay in shape like the world salsa champions. That's why we're studying with you guys. So we gotta strive to not lose our breath when we're dancing fast salsa. I don't know if we should try it again slow or if we should do it with the slower music to keep up with you guys.
Yeah.
Samantha, can you explain the transition one last time from, I think once we do the last cross, yes.
This one here, right? One.
Right there, yes.
Let's do it again. So once we finish our first basic, we go in first to the cue, one, two, three, cross over on four. I'm going to do this sideways so that you see how clear the weight transfer needs to be so that I can transition into the next one. When I mark my four, right, notice how, like, how this is going to align itself over the foot, right? So what happens is often we see this when we stay too long on our heels or we become back weighted, then we're marking the step, but we didn't actually do our weight transfer, and that's what is going to, with the music, make us late, right? So the idea is that as every step that I take, I want to align my pelvis over that step so that my weight is always forward and I'm not dancing sort of here, right? Always running after the knee. So make sure that you're keeping your knees bent. Keep your steps very short, right? So it's going to seem a lot faster because we're doing we're marking a full count. Yes, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So that is going to feel faster even if we're dancing to a slower tempo. So what we do to kind of keep our steps right up there with the tempo is keep them short, right? I keep everything small in my center so that I'm able to control it, knees a little bit bent, and pelvis always forward, okay? So with that in mind, let's recap the steps one more time. From the basic, one, two, three, five, here we go. Susie, one, two, three, step four, open five, tap, six, tap, one. Yes, so this is the second transition. We go one, this is five, six, seven, eight, one. And I'll do one more time sideways. Five, six, seven, eight, one. Right, so I'm completely stable over my one. Again, pelvis over the leg. My standing leg is slightly bent so that I can absorb that weight transfer and then go right into our next part, which was the figure from the five. One more time, open, five, six, seven, eight, cross, one, tap, tap, slowly from the top. Here we go. Basic, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 5. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Open 5, 7, 8. Cross 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, a little bit here.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely. That makes a lot of sense, especially. Always, right? Hip width is what helps, I think, everybody to dance under their feet, right under themselves. Right?
I just try to align. And also for social dancing, it helps a lot more once we're in control of our movement. So for me to be in control, I always want to step kind of with my legs at shoulder width apart, not too far. Yes, even if I want to travel, I'm going to use multiple steps to move into one direction, rather than try to take one huge step, right? That I can no longer control what my body's doing over that. So always think small steps, bend your knees, and that's actually gonna allow you to go create a bit more range of movement, right? A little bit more body movement, because you'll be able to control your weight that much better.
And after you do, Samantha, after you do the last step, are you doing a basic, right? After you do the combination and you ended up doing the combo here, you step it 5, or what are you exactly, how are you getting out of it at the very end of the combination?
So, how about add that in right now? Yeah.
So okay. So it's very clear, yes.
Let's finish that off. Yes.
Yes.
Move on to the music again. So let's take it from the top and we'll add that last part. Basic. 1, 2, 3, 5, cruise EQ. 1, 2, 3, cross 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, cross 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. We're going to tap our 5 with our knee coming inward, is behind on 6. Now I'm going to go kick forward 7, and then I'm going to do a cha-cha-cha, like a back break. And those sounds are going to be 8 and 1. Okay, so again, let's break that down. We did 1, we tap 2, tap 3, and I step 4. I'm going to repeat the same thing with my right leg. Tap 5, back 6, I kick 7 forward, 8 and 1. Yes? So what's really important here, again, I'm going to repeat myself, but it's super important. The standing leg needs to remain always aligned with the pelvis and slightly bent. I'll do the whole step again sideways. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Right, but notice those moments where I'm holding and I'm staying on the same leg. 5, 6, 7. I have 3 actions that I'm doing with my right leg, but my left one needs to remain really solid, right? Really anchored and grounded into the floor so that I can control that quickly with music. Nice, Talia, very good.
That makes sense. It's great to see you sometimes sideways too, because we get to see exactly what you're talking about, which is, you know, where are you positioning yourself? That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, let's try that again. Just this last section. So from the last, cross 1, tap 2, tap 3, step 4, repeat, 5, 6, I kick forward, 8 and 1. Okay, that cha-cha-cha at the end is 3 small weight transfers. So once we finish, 5, 6, we kick on the 7, 8 and 1. Right, left, right. So 8 and 1. And I'll do that sideways one more time. The kick will remain low, okay? You can obviously kick it a little bit higher, but this is gonna tend to be a little bit faster with the music. So again, question of control. We're gonna just lift the foot about an inch off the floor. You're gonna try and align your leg and keep it nice and active, right? The foot is slightly turned up, 7. And then I go 8 and 1. So I'm doing 3 full weight transfers, but I'm gonna mark it on the ball of the foot and 1. 1, I can drop my heel to anchor myself again to move forward into the next part. Okay, one more time, this last section. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 1. Basic 2, 3, 5, 6 and 10. Okay.
We try that from the top and put it all together slowly.
Yes.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Choose EQ, here we go. And 1, 2, 3, cross 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, cha-cha, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Yes? A little bit faster? Here we And 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Yes?
Beautiful, yes.
Fine. One more time, and then we'll go with music with that last 5, 6, 7, okay? Here we go. 5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, 3, here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cha cha. 1, 2, 5. Okay? We'll try it with some music.
Yes.
A little bit slower.
Remember to keep your steps small. Think knees bent, always with the weight forward on the ball of the foot so that you can affect. I was going to say that in French. So that you can complete all the weight transfers.
Yes.
And that's what happens when you live in Montreal. It's all like mixed up in there sometimes.
I love it. I love Montreal. I can't wait to go, but I feel like I go, every time I go, it's too cold. So even when I go in the summer, it's too cold. What's up with that?
We had a really great summer, but it's definitely a nice place to be in the summer.
Yeah, not in the winter.
Not in the winter. No.
Exactly. Not in the winter for sure. Yes.
All right, we'll do this with music. Here we go.
All right. Have a mojito right now to help me relax and just, you know, like move as fast as you guys do. I feel like it's not a mojito. I wish it was it's a ginger beer.
Oh, nice.
You know, I'm enjoying ginger beers. Usually with Pisco, I'm from Peru, so we get to mix it up and it's like a special drink, but this is a non-alcoholic beverage. Wow, I'm out of shape. You guys are making me sweat, but you know, that's what happens when you dance. You get to work out, you get to exercise.
You wanted to bring a little bit of heat.
That's the point of the whole thing, correct? Yeah, that's the point. That's beautiful. I have one more question. So you guys are so close to Cuba. Do you go to Cuba often?
We've been. Obviously, right now, I don't think many people are traveling right now under the circumstances, but we've been a couple of times, actually. It's about a 3.5-hour, 4-hour flight from Montreal.
You're right there. The first time I went to Cuba, it was back in the day where Americans couldn't go to Cuba, and I went with my Peruvian passport. I was an American resident, and I did the whole thing of dressed up. I had a hat, I had a wig, I had a mustache, glasses. You landed on one floor, you went to the bathroom, you dressed up, and you went as a new person because they were fining. Back then, they will fine people thousands of dollars for going from here. So, but I had to go, you know, I went and it was so amazing. I got to meet Los Muñequitos de Matanza, which a lot of your moves remind me of them. You know, they're very folkloric and they have all these things with the, you even did a performance that you had the red, the red del pañuelo is the yeah. word in English. Right. It's like, you know what I mean? Like you were dancing with very Cuban style. It was so cool. And I'm like, well, that's, you guys, it's so much easier for you guys to immerse into Cuban culture when you're in Montreal. It's right there, you know, that's awesome. But that's great. I am enjoying this. This is a workout, you guys. This is beautiful. You are obviously, you've been dancing through quarantine.
Yes.
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 Yeah, it shows.
We were on a TV show here in Montreal last year that we were on tour with right before COVID hit. So we were dancing pretty much every day.
And yeah, actually, I will be posting. I'm going to be for our viewers and for the thousands of viewers that we'll get tonight, because people watch this also later when they're having their dinner, you know, and when they make themselves the mojito, they are watching this and they're hopefully joining. So I'm going to place and one of my favorite routines that you guys perform in the Revolución show, which is what really excited me to have you guys on our virtual Sunset Salsa, because I'm like, wow, they're very good. I mean, you not only do all those tricks, but also your dancing is very authentic. And that's what I enjoy the most when I watch you dance. You know, like you're also a great social dancer. So you do a lot of social dancing yourselves?
Yes, of course. Every time we had either a congress or even if it was just social events here in Montreal, whenever we're performing, we usually stay and social dance with everybody, and we usually have a lot of fun.
So. I miss it.
And we miss it a lot. We miss it a lot.
Well, you probably were traveling every weekend, right?
Yes, we were a little bit everywhere before this, and then.
Right, that's right. And now you're stuck practicing. Well, that's not too bad.
We gotta look at the positive.
That's right. We get to study with you guys. So that wouldn't happen if it was for this. So I feel like I've been taking classes also online from people like Debbie Allen and all these famous people that I always want to take class with. And I never was able to for one reason or another. So now everybody's virtual, which is really great to be able to study. So it is a good time to study, I suppose. We have to make the best of it. But when you're in New York next, you have to come and teach in person at Sunset Salsa next summer. So you should plan to be here either in June, July, or August, so you can actually come and experience Sunset Salsa or what Sunset Salsa is all about, because it's a beautiful outdoor event where thousands of people go to dance. And really you get a sense of, you know, the melting pot that is New York from the people, but also the music and the air. And it's just a great event. So I'm inviting you way in advance. So next year, yes?
Awesome.
All right, fantastic. So I feel like, let me see, how are we doing with the questions? I think we're doing good with the time. I feel like maybe we'll have time for 1-8, because then I want people to dance a little bit more. I know I want to practice with you guys, and we want to learn maybe one more little combination or some arm style. I mean, your arms are beautiful, so maybe you want to teach us something fun to do with our arms, and then we can dance one final dance, and nothing too fast, I think, because, you know, you guys are young people. I mean, you're like, what, 25%? Your viewers, you got to stay with your audience. I love it.
All right, so let's add in one more bar, yeah?
Yes.
Take it back from the beginning.
Yes.
7, 8, basic, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, open 5. 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, kick 7, 8, and 1, 2. Yes? Yeah? So from here, we're going to go into a right turn right away. So from our cha-cha, one,
right turn, 2, 3, close on 5, and then we're gonna go into a side break turn, 6, we open. I'm gonna start pivoting on my 7, so 7, 2 or left, 1, and jump, 2, 3, back to basic, 6, 7. Okay, let's break that down. So we did, we added one right turn, and then a side break, left turn. Here we go. From the figure from the last section, crossover 1, tap 2, tap 3, step 4, tap 5, tap 6, kick 7, 8, and 1. We're going to turn to the right. 2, 3, 5 together. We're going to make sure to transfer your weight onto the left leg on 5.
Your center.
In your center, small step. So you want to bring that leg as close to your right as possible. Transfer the weight so you can open and then rotate to the other side and 1. So on 1, we're going to extend the right leg here and chuck forward, 2, 3, basic, 5, 6, 7. Okay? Now for ladies, if you want to add some sliding into that right turn, I'll give you guys a couple of options. So we can go into a wrap, 2, 3, 5, 6. So what I like to do is I raise my forearm right just above the level of my elbows. We're gonna do one rotation toward the inside, and then I'm going to wrap my right arm around my left hip and my left arm to the back of the right hip, right? And then I'm gonna use all of the counts of the turn so that it doesn't look rushed. So on the 1, I'll raise my arms. I'll rotate the wrist. 2, I'll wrap. And then as I'm coming out of the turn, by 5, I want to release that so I come back into my frame for the next movement. And that would be one option. And if not, we can do 1, up on 2, down behind the head on 3. And again, by 5, I want to release the arms so I can properly come back to frame for the next part. Okay, so those arms would be down on 1. I'm going to go up through the side, all the way up. Try and keep your arms extended for this, so don't go halfway, yes? All the way up, and then I'm gonna bend out of my elbows first. Cross the arms behind the head, all the way down, and then you can let them come across the body all the way to the hips. By 5, release, 6, 7, turn. Okay, so up to you, whichever option, wrap or hair comb during the turn. Okay, let's try that. Let's take it again from the top and add that last section. Basic, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3. Here we go. 2, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, tap, 2, 3, 4. Tap, 5, 6, 8, 7, 8, and 1. Right turn. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Open. 2, 3, 5, and 6, 7. Yeah. One more time.
Yes.
5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6, 7. You can also hair comb on that chuck as well. Optional, yes?
We'll do just that right turn with the hair comb, actually. We'll try that one. So we go forward 1, right turn 2, 3, together on 5, open 6, 7, and here we're gonna go right directly. Once we extend the right leg, we can go over the head with a hair comb, 2, into the chuck, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay? One more time, we'll try just that. 5, 6, 7, right turn, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, hair comb. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. One last time, a little bit faster. 5, 6, 7, right turn. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and a 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. Yes, from the top.
Yes.
5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and here we go, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. One more time.
Wow. Yes.
Here we go. 5, 6, 7, basic. 1, 2, 3, and a 5. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1. Right turn. 5, 6, 7, and help. 2, 3, 5, 6, up. Yeah?
Beautiful. Yes. Very nice.
Okay. One last thing. It's going to be really short, but I want to do it just to give you guys one little extra. It's not really hard, okay?
Bonus. Okay.
Little bonus, yes. So we go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. We're stepping on the 3 with the right leg. And then from here, all we're going to do is a body roll. 5, 6, 7, 8. Just the knees. 7, 8, and basic, 2, 3. Okay? So one little body roll, cheeky, cheeky, 1, 2, 3. Yeah? So let's try that with the right turn. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, body roll, cheeky, cheeky, and 1, 2, yeah?
Love it, very fun, yes. Nice.
Have fun with that last part, ladies, if you want to do the knees, or we can also go body roll up, or maybe chest, just the hip, right? So just have fun with that last part.
All right.
We try the music? Nice.
Yes, please.
Here we go. 1 second.
And that's going to be our final dance, I think. My hair that is growing now. This is fantastic. You got us working out here. And I'm really excited because, again, a lot of people will be able to watch it tonight as well. And we have also a playlist. It's been curated by an amazing Colombian artist, Santiago Moyano, who sings also with La Sonora Carruseles and the fantastic Proyecto, escaped my name right now, but he's a Grammy nominated artist as well. So he's amazing. So we're gonna be pinning that so people can stay home, practice to some amazing salsa. And of course, I'm gonna be practicing your moves. They are so original and they're so beautiful. Thank you so much for the arm style and the options to get groovy. And it's all about, right, developing your own personality on the dance floor as well. Yeah. Right? So I think that people should have fun and explore different things, and we never stop learning, which is really the most amazing thing. And you guys know that. I mean, look at your accomplishments at such a young age. So thank you so much for joining us tonight. And
thank you so much for
all the way from Montreal, Canada. And when you go to Montreal, I want to go social dancing. Next time I go to Montreal, I want to go to the jazz festival. So I'm definitely going to stop by your studio now. And I'm sure you have great socials in the winter, right? Because people have to dance in the winter. So I am looking forward to checking that out when I'm next time in Montreal. And we'll share that information also with our viewers. And I think, I don't know if we're waiting for Kira or not, but this was fantastic. We learned so much from you guys. I'm going to be sharing your videos so people can see you perform and see what is that, you know, you worked so hard to achieve. And congratulations once again on all your accomplishments. And
thank you so much.
Yeah, thank
it you, was
Kira.
Wonderful to have you all. Thank you. And
were you dancing with us,
time.
I hope?
Yes, I was. And tell us one more time, Adriano and Samantha, how we can find you on social media and your website.
Yes, so you could find us at Adriano y Samantha
on Instagram
and on Facebook on both of our pages. And you can also check out Nova Era Productions, so NovaeraProductions.com, which is our dance studio's website, and it has all of our information. And if you'd like to contact us through our email as well. And that's it.
I just posted it on the link. So thank you so much, guys. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup.
Merci, merci.
Merci, merci. And I look forward to seeing you hopefully in New York or in Montreal. So
yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Hudson River Park, Kira. And we'll see you guys next week at 7 with another amazing virtual Sunset Salsa. Stay well, stay happy, stay dancing. Keep dancing at home with the link. Bye-bye.